Hello students of class 12. Welcome to the online tutorial classes for Vidya Bhavan High Secondary School. This video is for class 12 nutrition. The chapter that I will going to discuss is the metabolism of the food. This is the 9th video from this chapter. In this video, we are going to discuss about the gluconeogenesis. In the previous video, we completed the part till the glycogenolysis, that means the glycogen breakdown. Here we are going to start with the gluconeogenesis or neoglucogenesis. Both are same. Okay, so here neo means new. Gluco means you already know that the glucose, and genesis means synthesis. So altogether it is the new glucose synthesis. Okay, it is the process to formation of the glucose, the process of formation of glucose from the non carbohydrate sources termed as gluconeogenesis or neoglucogenesis. So it is the procedure by which from the non-carbohydrate groups the glucose are produced. Okay, so the new production of the glucose or new synthesis of the glucose is called gluconeogenesis, and mainly from the pyruvic acid. So as usually they are produced from the any intermediate of the Krebs cycle can be produced, and mainly the glucogenic amino acids that can be produced, and the propionyl CoA from this can be produced. These are the further things from these it can be produced. And from CO2 also it can be produced. So let's check up how it can be produced or how this functioning are going on. In the gluconeogenesis, that means the new glucose formation or the process of formation of glucose from non-carbohydrate sources is termed as gluconeogenesis, as I told already. In this process, glucose may be formed from the following non-carbohydrate sources, like from pyruvic acid by the reversal glycolysis, that means the opposite reaction of the glycolysis, from any intermediate of the Krebs cycle, and also from glucogenic amino acids by transamination, that means the transfer of the amine group, from the propionyl CoA, that is the end product of the odd number of carbon containing fatty acid breakdown, and sometimes from CO2 in plants by photophosphorylation or sometimes photosynthesis. So here it is the flow chart. By this you can understood it very properly, that how the glucose can be generated from the non-glucose or non-carbohydrate sources. So here it is, that first that I can tell you, that here you can see one CO2, that is from the atmospheric CO2. From this CO2 is taken by the plants, and from the plants the photosynthesis happens, and you know every plant can prepare their food with the help of taking carbon dioxide that is excreted out by us and they are producing oxygen as well as starch molecules in their plants or in their body. And because it is the function of one tree, so here the glucose can be produced by it. Secondly, I can tell about one new thing, that is the fat. So after the fat digestion, the fatty acid and glycerol usually form. So here from the fatty acid and the glycerol, the propanyl CoA can be formed, and this propanyl CoA can prepare glycogen or can prepare glucose in this process. It is also one production procedure of the glucose from the fat mainly. The next is, I'll tell you from the amino acid. It is a complicated way. It is called the transamination. Transamination is nothing but the transfer of the amine group from the amino acids from one to another, from transfer from one amino acid to another. Okay, so here the amino acids by the transamination can form the keto acid. So that means the ketone groups are produced, that is C double bond O group. If this keto group can go for the Krebs cycle, and finally the oxaloacetic acid produced, and by this the phosphoenol pyruvic acids is formed as by the intermediate of the Krebs cycle, and from this phosphoenol pyruvic acid the reversal of the glycolysis, that means the opposite reaction of the glycolysis can happen, and that can produce the glucose. And one more pathway is here, that if the pyruvic acid is present in between, then it can also supply acetyl CoA that will run the Krebs cycle properly, and also it will give the pyruvic acid to the phosphoenol pyruvic acid to form the phosphoenol pyruvic acid mainly, that will help the reversal of the glycolysis. So it is the all over procedure of gluconeogenesis or neoglucogenesis.
Students of 12, I think you understood the basic reactions or learned about what are the non-carbohydrate products from which the new glucoses are forming, new glucose are synthesizing. So in the next video, we are going to discuss about the hexose monophosphate shunt pathway. Till then, thank you.